I work in mechanical vibrations and dynamics. So this is the study of motion of machines and structures and things. There are cases where you want vibrations. For example, you may want something to oscillate. Musical instruments is a perfect example. Then there are cases where you don't want vibrations, say in a car when you're driving down the road. And so we actually work with automotive companies, for example, on engine vibrations. The type of work that I do has to do with modeling. You build mathematical and computer models of how these systems behave so you can predict what's going to happen. Then you can design based on those models and then actually build in the laboratory and test and experiments. And with the car companies, we're actually translating a lot of this technology into things that will be in production. In engines, vibration is tied to fuel economy. For example, you can buy engines now where different numbers of cylinders in the engine are active depending on the load requirement of the car. But these can only operate in certain regimes because the vibrations become excessive due to the way the engine operates in these with a reduced number of cylinders. And so by designing what we have these devices called centrifugal pendulum vibration absorbers, we can actually smooth out the engine twisting or torsional vibrations. And this allows these engines to operate over a wider range of speeds and loads in this reduced cylinder mode, which actually improves fuel economy. I really enjoy working with students. The research wouldn't happen without them because I don't have enough hours in my week. I mean, research would be much slower. So, and the thing I like about the students is they bring youth energy. Even sometimes just asking what they think are stupid questions sometimes are actually good questions, you know, make me think about things in new ways.